You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Uzma Jafri, and today in our episode of My India, we will take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. A famous writer of Indian origin, Siddharth Katragadda, once said, "The greatness of a culture can be found in its festivals." And so, the greatness of a country like India can be examined by sparing a glance at the vivid and vivacious list of festivals celebrated here. Ranging from harvest to the one dedicated to several gods and goddesses, the country celebrates n number of festivals throughout the year. One among this list is the Chhath Puja that was recently observed with great joy and enthusiasm across different parts of the country.
Scores of devotees across India thronged the water bodies to celebrate the ancient Hindu Vedic festival, Chhath, where they prayed to the rising sun for the well-being and prosperity of the children and spouse. Dedicated to the sun god and his wives, Usha and Sandhya, the four-day festival starts on the sixth day after Diwali and holds immense significance for married women who observe, fast and stand in waist-deep water and present religious offerings to the sun. The rituals and traditions of the festival are very hard, as the vrati or the devotees fast for 36 hours without having a single bite of food or a drop of water. According to the tradition, on the first day, also known as Nahakhai, devotees take a bath, particularly in the river Ganga, and bring the holy water of the river to make prasad at home. On the second day, also known as Kharna, devotees make offerings that comprise of kheer, puris, chapatis and bananas, besides observing fast for the whole day. These items are then distributed to the family and neighbors after worshipping Chhathi Mai, also known as Goddess Usha.
Aaj kharna hai aur kharna pe gud ki kheer aur roti ka mahatv hai aur jitne bhi log vrat karte hain wo log bahut shraddha ke sath aur bahut matlab ullas ke sath ye parv ka ye karte hain jashn manate hain aur hum log gud ki kheer aur roti bana ke aur chhath maa ka pooja karte hain jitne log vrat kiye hue hain वे लोग सब लोग अब फिर नए कपड़े पहनेंगे उसके बाद हम लोग बना के फिर छठ माँ का पूजा करके और फिर रोटी और खीर फल ये सब लेके हम लोग फिर खरना करते हैं और छठ का पर्व हम लोग बहुत हर्षोल्लास से मनाते हैं और बहुत खुश होके हम लोग ये व्रत करते हैं और ये कामना करते हैं कि हम लोग सब लोग स्वस्थ और सुखी रहें और संपन्न रहें
The toughest is the third day of Chhath when devotees, mostly women, observe a rigid fast where they neither consume water nor food. In the evening, they go to the bank of the river or pond carrying along them with dowry, a basket made up of bamboo sticks in which they keep the offerings that comprise of tikua, puri, coconut, banana and other seasonal fruits. Then after Sandhya Arg to the sun god, Kosi is celebrated. Kosi is usually earthen pots or lamps that are kept under the shade of 5 or 24 sugarcane sticks tied with a yellow cloth. Bhinaya is the final day of this holy festival on which devotees gathered at the bank of the river early in the morning to present their offering to the rising sun, following which they break their fast. During all 4 days, devotees observe purity and live frugally and thank sun god and his wives for showering blessings and sustaining life and energy on earth.
लेकिन हमारा जो सनातन धर्म है ये भी इसका
आद या अंत नहीं है, इसीलिए अस्ताचलगामी सूर्य को भी अर्घ्य दी जाती है और फिर सूर्योदय जो होता है उनको भी दी जाती है। तात्पर्य यह कि सूर्य की किरणें जो बिना भेदभाव का हर वर्ग के घर में जाती है किरणें, ठीक उसी प्रकार से हम लोगों को भी समझना चाहिए। मेरा घर का मुखिया एक है, मेरा मालिक एक है, न वर्ण न धर्म कुछ भी नहीं, हम एक साथ सम्मिलित होकर के सूर्य की उपासना करते हैं।
Chhath is considered as one of the most significant and auspicious festivals of northern Bihar state and in parts of neighboring Uttar Pradesh. With time, the festival has also gained popularity in metropolitan cities as people from these states migrate in large numbers to make a living.
India is a land where Sufism has just not flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Taking forward this legacy of peace and brotherhood, a cultural fest was organized in the beautiful Gulmarg town of Jammu and Kashmir that was thronged by people from across the state, irrespective of their caste and communities.
A day-long cultural fest, Mannate Aman or Pray for Peace, was organized by the Indian Army with support of local musicians at Baba Rishi Shrine at Gulmarg in the Baramulla district of Jammu and Kashmir. Celebrating the Sufi heritage of syncretism in the region, people from different parts of the state came in unison to witness the cultural fest.
ये कश्मीर में शांति और अमन लाने के लिए किया गया था और इसमें जो सबसे अहम जो सेंट्रल आइडिया था वो ये था कि जो स्पिरिचुअल फिलासफी है हमारी जो सूफियत है उसको उसका प्रचार किया जाए क्योंकि यही वो वाहिद ज़रिया है जिसके ज़रिए से हम लोगों को आपस में जोड़ सकते हैं जो मोहब्बत का मसावात का मजहबी रवादारी का पैगाम देता है।
The shrine of revered Sufi saint Payamuddin, popularly known as Baba Rishi, provided a perfect backdrop for the audience to immerse in the spirit of pristine and pious Sufi music. Qawwali and ghazals by noted artists Shafi Sopori, Manzoor Ul Haq, Munir Ahmed Ganai and Tariq Ahmed Bhatt enthralled the audience.
आज हमने सूफ़ी नगमे गाए, यहाँ सूफ़ी कलाम पढ़ा और भी कई गुलकार थे जिन्होंने अपने फ़न का मुजाहरा किया लोगों के सामने और हमें भी बहुत ही अच्छा लगा। आज ये मेरे हिसाब से मेरा ये पहली बार है किसी दरगाह के आंगन में और सूफ़ी कलाम पढ़ना और मैं समझता हूँ कि ये मेरे लिए बाज़े फ़ख्र की बात है और मैं शुक्रगुज़ार हूँ मौला का, उन्होंने यहाँ पे मौका दिया है।
A large number of children and youth were seen mesmerized by the traditional music and different forms of poetry. The initiative aimed to introduce youth to the charismatic Sufi music that is above religion and diversifications.
कि सूफीज़म इज़ द रिलीजन ऑफ ह्यूमैनिटी एंड यूनिटी, तो इसमें दोनों, इसमें किसी के साथ कोई भेदभाव नहीं है, कोई बैर नहीं है किसी के साथ, तो हमने यही रास्ता चुना और इस इवेंट का मकसद यही था कि हमारी रियासत में पीस कायम हो और हमारे साथ लोग जुड़ें और हमारे इवेंट्स के साथ आया करें जहाँ पर भी हम, ना कि सूफीज़म के साथ इवेंट करते। इससे पहले चिनार फेस्ट किया था जो हमने ऑर्गेनाइज़ किया था, हाँ आर्मी का कहीं कहीं सपोर्ट रहता है, वो बहुत ज़रूरी कि उनके इनकी, क्योंकि हमारे सूफीज़म में कोई बैर नहीं है कि वो ये है, तो मकसद है अमन, पीस, सलामती सबकी।
The event saw enthusiastic response from tourists and locals alike. The event was a great success in promoting tourism while spreading the message of love, respect, tolerance and syncretism among the people.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Indian Space Agency recently launched its fifth communication satellite successfully from spaceport of Sriharikota. Chairman of Indian Space Research Organization ISRO, Dr. K. Sivan, while addressing a news conference, announced the successful launch of GSLV Mk3, which carried the heaviest satellite from India soil, GSAT-29.
Just now we have come out of the a very, very grand, successful launch of GSLV Mark 3, the second development flight, which launches or which carry the heaviest satellite, TSAT-29, from Indian soil.
ISRO blasted off its heaviest rocket geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle MK3 carrying GSAT-29 satellite at 5:08 p.m. The satellite, which weighs 3,423 kg, was taken into the Earth geosynchronous orbit, braving adverse weather conditions generated by Cyclone Gaja. It will help meet the communication requirements of people in remote parts of the country. The Indian Space Agency is also working on launching its first manned space mission by 2022 that will aim to send a 3-member crew to space for 5 to 7 days in a craft that will be placed in low Earth orbit of 300 to 400 kilometers. The second edition of the Make in Odisha Conclave 2018, a flagship biennial global investors meet, was recently held in the state capital of Bhubaneswar with Japan as the partner country for the event. The theme of the conclave, I Am Odisha, intended to convey the achievements and success of the state and its citizens to the global community. It saw a participation of more than 5,000 industry captains so far, with delegates from across the country and abroad, and experienced a footfall of up to 31,000. The conclave received an overall investment intent of ₹4,19,574 crore across 15 sectors, with claims to create up to 5,91,000 additional jobs.
At this second edition of the Make in Odisha conclave, we look forward to interact with all of you and deliberate upon the vast opportunities that Odisha offers and how we can work together towards developing Odisha as a manufacturing hub of South Asia.
The Make in Odisha Conclave promises to further the vision of the state to broad-base the industrial growth with investment proposals in several sectors, including chemical and fertilizers, petrochemical, food processing, healthcare, tourism, renewable energy and electronics. Scores of Indian and international stars from the film industries marked their presence at 24th Kolkata International Film Festival that was held recently. The event was inaugurated by India's Eastern West Bengal State Chief Mamata Banerjee and legendary Bollywood actor Amitabh Bachchan, along with stars like Shah Rukh Khan, veteran actress Wahida Rahman, filmmaker Mahesh Bhatt, Iranian director Majid Majidi and many others.
In a world which is getting so much closer with technology and accessories, there is still something which is making us all extremely divisive. And the only thing that can bring us together is one or the other form of art.
The week-long festival also celebrated 100 years of Bengali cinema and showcased a total of 171 movies and 150 short films from 70 countries in 16 screens during the film festival. A new dome coach was added to the heritage Kalka Shimla toy train in the hill town of Shimla. A trial run of the new coach was conducted recently. Vista dome coach having see-through toughened glass plies between Kalka and Shimla. This aesthetically designed coach called Nihar is the first of its kind in the region and is installed to give the passengers, especially tourists, a chance to savor the beauty of the picturesque hills in a panoramic view.
And this is included in the UNESCO site, and the train is so wonderful, as you can see, and the appearance of this train is also like a toy, as the name suggests us. So the train is so mesmerizing, and really we remember it for forever in our life.
The Kalka-Shimla railway line was declared the UNESCO's World Heritage Line in 2008. It has been a great tourist attraction since then, and now the new coach will add to the experience even more.
Today in our section of Asia Buzz, we will see how Japanese companies are laying great impetus on disaster preparedness as well as tourism promotion. Recently, where Aeon conducted a disaster preparedness event for the regular customers, on the other side, Osaka Tourism Bureau partnered with JCB in order to increase tourist inflow in the city. A report.
Aeon Shinonome store conducted disaster prevention event for the general customer in case of a disaster situation. In recent days, various natural disasters have devastated life in different regions around the world. And for many people, disaster preparation is not an optional measure, but a prerequisite. AEON has been doing many kinds of disaster preparedness measure to provide safety and security for all customers. In this seminar, disaster prevention expert was invited from Koto Ward to give instruction on preparation measures based on past disaster experience.
イオンさんの方から、お話がありまして、今回、防災関係のちょっとセミナーをやりたいので、ちょっと講話をお願いしたいというふうに言われまして、で、お受けいたしました。皆さん個人個人でやっぱり防災に関して関心が高いと思うんです。多分イオンさんの方でもこの防災について色々と考えていただいてますので、そういうことで区とも連携をしていきたいなと思っておりますので。自助共助、ね、っていうのは大事だっていうのも分かりましたし、あとは、備蓄品とかもね、どれくらい用意しておけばいいのかとか、そういうのも分かったので、とても良かったと思ってます。
During disaster drill, AEON collaborated with companies related to disaster prevention and introduced the latest preparedness measure to customers. This shelter can be used both on land and underwater in urgent disaster situation. It can contain two people inside. In a disaster situation, many pets too suffer unexpected circumstances and endure a lot of stress. AEON Pet provides pet treatment and management service for pet and owner. One of the most important preparations for a disaster is food. AEON recommends rolling stock as disaster preparedness measure. Rolling stock is a cycle of keeping certain amounts of foods in house at all times. This means regularly eating items from your stockpile and then replacing them with new items to keep the situation close to daily life even in an emergency.
食品もですね、やっぱ同じように、なかなかローリングストックとか備蓄という概念がないもんですから、例えば防災備蓄ボックスみたいなやつを作って、それを販売することで備蓄に逆に慣れていく。 そういうことを展望として考えております。ただ買い物をするだけではなく、やっぱり暮らしのライフラインとして、やっぱりイオンが地域に愛されるために防災拠点として流れて頑張ってやっていこうというのを思ってます。It
is not easy to prepare for a sudden disaster. However, Japanese company continues preparation for disaster to keep safety for customers. Next, we will see how Osaka, one of the most popular cities in Japan among foreign tourists, is finding out ways to increase the tourist inflow. Osaka has a thriving business and is known as Merchant Town with its unique signboard along energetic shopping streets. Osaka Tourism Bureau is engaged in a variety of initiatives to let many foreign visitors know about Osaka. At Osaka Tourism Bureau's conference in October, the Bureau announced that this year Japan suffered from disasters such as earthquake and typhoon, and there is a fear of the negative impact on tourism.
Thai Malaysia is removed from the visa, and it is even bigger, and the income level is also higher. So, this is also very
In order to increase the inflow of tourists from Southeast Asia, Osaka Tourism Bureau have partnered with private company JCB, which is one of the original credit card companies in Japan.
Osaka というキャンペーンを来年の3月末までやって徹底的にこの大阪の魅力をですね、タイの会員に通じてタイ国に訴えていきたい。
JCB has many members in the Asian country and it has already provided them with special preferential service in approximately 1,000 stores in Japan. The newly added service, Otoko Osaka campaign, is related to JCB card issued in Thailand. The campaign's logo has a unique design of Osaka's famous features such as the Osaka Castle and Tokoyaki, etc.
タイで発行しております JCB の会員様向けのキャンペーンとなっております。大阪の南エリアで約60店舗の皆様に優待店となっていただいておりまして、そちらで JCB カードを使っていただければギフトカードをもらっていただいたり、割引をさせていただいたり、タイに戻ってからカードの使用料金を支払いする際にキャッシュバックがされるような優待を用意しております。 日本の歴史からして大阪は商人の街と言われております。でそこからキャンペーンのキャッチフレーズもお得大阪となっている通り、お得に皆様にショッピングをしていただき、食事を楽しんでいただくことを期待しております。
The number of tourists from Southeast Asia is increasing because it is becoming easier to obtain an entry visa to Japan. As local government and business companies prepare various services to attract those travelers, there is no doubt that they will have a more enjoyable time in Japan.
To me, India is a land of beauty and generosity, of traditional hospitality and the acceptance of many cultures. These words by Vijayalakshmi Pandit have been proved right by Indians from time to time. There are several initiatives taken by the people in order to serve humanity by working above religious lines. One such example was presented by an industry in the Jhargham district of West Bengal, where a canteen was recently opened to serve free lunch to its workers belonging to different religions, castes and communities. Take a look.
With an aim to foster religious communion amongst the industry workers of Jhargham district in West Bengal, the UAL Bengal industry recently inaugurated a canteen to provide free lunch to its workers. Soon after the inauguration, the workers were invited for a grand feast prepared by the kitchen staff employed by the industry.
আজকে যেরকম একটা প্রোগ্রাম যে আমরা করেছি অ্যাবাউট দি ফুড, দিস ফুড সাপ্লাই, দিস হ্যাজ বিন আমার মাইন্ডে অনেক দিন ছিল কীভাবে এটাকে করা যায়। আর বিকজ যারা আসছে এখান থেকে, দে ইফ আই এম প্রোভাইডিং দেম ফ্রি লাঞ্চ, দেন এই লাঞ্চ যে ওরা, ওদের আর কোনো চিন্তা ভাবনা নেই কি ওরা আবার বাড়ি থেকে উতারা দরকার নেই, এখান থেকে আবার ফিরে গিয়ে আবার যে, সো দিস দে অ্যান্ড দে গেভ গেট গুড হাইজিন লাঞ্চ, হট লাঞ্চ, গরম খাবার খেতে পাবে। অ্যান্ড পিওরলি দিস হ্যাজ বিন অন দি আউট অফ হিউম্যানিটি, দ্যাটস ইট।
As queue of workers waited outside the canteen for their turn, a large batch of workers had already finished eating their lunch, giving way to their friends.
টিচার মানে সহানুভূতি দেখাচ্ছেন এবং খাওয়া দাওয়া খুব স্ট্যান্ডার্ডেই হয়েছে, খুব ভালো লাগছে, খুব আনন্দিত হচ্ছে আর কি।
সুবিধা আমাদের সমস্ত রকম সুবিধা হবে, খাওয়া দাওয়াটা ফ্রিতে, এখানে কোনো পয়সা লাগে না।
কি মনে হচ্ছে?
খাওয়া দাওয়া খুব ভালো হয়েছে, সব দিকেই ভালো, পরিষ্কার পরিচ্ছন্নতা আমাদের সবটাই বজায় রাখতে পারছি আর কি।
The canteen can provide lunch to more than 700 to 800 workers every day. The initiative received praise from across the multi-religious societies residing in the Jhargham district. The canteen opened in Tunga Dhova area not just provide lunch but ensues a feeling of oneness and unity among the workers coming from diverse sections and religions of the society.
Every year, India's southern state of Kerala comes alive during the monsoon season with the colourful boat festivals which bring out the rich tradition and diverse culture of the state. However, this year the event got postponed owing to devastating floods that brought life in the state to a standstill, but not for long. The people in Kerala sprung to action and within a matter of weeks, they were all set to organise the world famous snake boat race in the backwaters of Kerala. Take a look.
Thumping paddles, rhythmic movements and whirling roars of spectators marked the famous snake boat race in the backwaters of Kerala. Popularly known as Vallam Kali, this year's Nehru Trophy boat race saw participation of 80 snake boats sharing through the Punnamda Lake to win the coveted rolling trophy. Teams have to go through several preliminary rounds before making it to the top four who battle it out in the finals. Much before the snake boat berths at the starting line, large crowds of local spectators and tourists dot the banks of Punnamada Lake in Alafuzha city of Kerala. Snake boat race, the spectacular event of the year, is conducted in August every year. However, it was postponed this time till October owing to the devastating floods the state suffered few months back. It was indeed a moment of pride for the country when the state of Kerala sprung back to action and conducted the famous boat race even after suffering the fierce floods this year.
We've always wanted to see the boat race and we got a chance to see it because it got postponed from August. And I have not seen such an atmosphere anywhere around. And this is so exciting. I'm here with my family and we are all excited.
Snake boats date back to the 13th century when they were first commissioned as war boats during the reign of King Devanarayana. Vallamkali or snake boat race was later christened Nehru Trophy boat race only after the first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, visited Kerala in the year 1952. Since then, the snake boat race is organized every year in the backwaters of Kerala.
It's fantastic. It's really, really good. I didn't actually know it was taking place until I arrived yesterday. So I'm so grateful to be here and to experience it. It's totally amazing. I've never seen anything like it.
This year, Pai Paran Chundan boat, crewed by the Palathuruthi Boat Club, emerged victorious in the 1.4-kilometer race. Enthused spectators standing at the finish line welcomed the teams with reverberating cheers, marking the end of famous snake boat race of India. More than just a race, the event is a manifestation of traditional culture and lifestyle of the fishing communities residing in the backwaters of God's own country, Kerala.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at suggest.myindia@gmail.com. I'm your host, Uzma Jafri, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.